Happiness, not just a word, a whole phenomenon for which the whole universe is fighting. But the means of happiness is not same for everyone. For one person, maybe money is happiness, but maybe for the person, having daily meals at time or seeing his or her family members happy is the best feeling. Once, Dalai Lama said, "Happiness is not something ready-made, it comes from your own actions." So, let's know how to feed your soul with the river of happiness. Number 1. Be the master of your mind. Happiness often comes from within. Learn how to tame negative thoughts and approach every day with optimism. Number 2. Conquer negative thinking. The first thing to acknowledge when you have a negative mindset, that means if you have problems at work, tell yourself that I am obsessing about problems at work, and then use the art of Socratic questioning, like, could I be misinterpreting the situation? How might other people view the situation differently? How might I view this situation if it happened to someone else? For more detail about Socratic question, check the link above. Number 3. Controlled breathing. Science is just beginning to provide evidence that the benefits of this ancient practice are real. Studies have found, for example, that breathing practices can help reduce symptoms associated with anxiety, insomnia, post-traumatic stress disorder, depression, and attention deficit disorder. For centuries, yogis have used breath control or pranayama to promote concentration and improve vitality. Buddha advocated breath meditation as a way to reach enlightenment. Number 4. Get moving. When people get up and move, even a little, they tend to be happier than when they are still. A study that tracked the movement and moods of cell phone users found that people reported the most happiness if they had been moving in the past 15 minutes than when they had been sitting or lying down. Most of the time, it wasn't rigorous activity but just gentle walking that left them in a good mood. Number 5. Practice optimism. Optimism is part genetic, part learned. Even if you were born into a family of gloomy gooses, you can still find your inner ray of sunshine. Optimism doesn't mean ignoring the reality of a dire situation. After a job loss, for instance, many people may feel defeated and think, I'll never recover from this. An optimist would acknowledge the challenge in a more hopeful way, saying, this is going to be difficult, but it's a chance to rethink my life goals and find work that truly makes me happy. So yeah. The key to being happy is knowing of what to accept and what to let go. Be happy and keep smiling. See you in the next video.